watching KETV Channel 7 Omaha. More complete coverage. This is KETV News Watch 7 at 10.
State lawmakers passed a law that would allow convicted drunk drivers to install breath testing equipment in their cars. If you've been drinking, the car won't start. Good evening, I'm Julie Cornell.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. Rob McCartney is off tonight. In a unanimous 43-0 vote, state lawmakers passed a law that would allow drunk drivers to apply for a restricted driving permit while their license is revoked. KETV News Watch 7's Owen Lay is live along Interstate 80 with tonight's big story.
The devices are called ignition interlocks, and basically they test your blood alcohol level to determine if they're going to let you drive or not. Now, currently a judge has to order you to get those installed, but supporters of the new proposed law say they hope that would make it a more viable option for both judges and law enforcement. Basically, it's installed like a remote engine starter. But for this device, you have to be both in the car and not drunk for your car to start.
Starts right up like normal.
John Hunter has installed more than 1,000 of these ignition interlock breath testing computers, and if the governor signs a new bill into law, Hunter could be installing many more.
Once you have it installed, you get our installation papers, you'll take that to the DMV as proof of installation, then you'll get a restricted license.
Here's how the law would work. The DMV revokes licenses of first-time DUI offenders for 90 days. After the first 30, they could apply for an ignition interlock permit, or IIP. Second-time offenders lose their license for a year, but could apply for an IIP after 60 days. In both cases, drivers can only drive to work, school, treatment programs, and the interlock service center.
Instead of someone losing their job over this, they can still get back and forth to work.
That's a privilege extended to people that would otherwise not drive during a set period.
Douglas County Sheriff Sergeant Rob Jones likes the idea of having an extra tool to keep tabs on drunk drivers, but he says you can't close all the loopholes.
What experience has shown us that just because someone doesn't have the privilege to drive, if their license is suspended or revoked, doesn't guarantee that they're not going to get behind the wheel.
Now, the IIP would cost $45, 40 of which would go towards helping people who can't afford interlock installation, because those usually run up to about $150, I'm sorry, at least $150. Governor Heineman's office says he's still looking at it and has not decided whether or not to sign the bill.
Owen, would all drunk drivers be eligible under the law?
Not necessarily. There are scenarios where you would not be allowed to have an interlock permit. Drunk drivers who refuse a breath test would lose that privilege. Third-time offenders could also have to wait years before they're considered for an IIP. And a judge can also, quote, impound a license, which would take away any chance of an IIP.
All right. Owen, thanks.